guys, today is our success talk. Again, we have Dr. Aparna CT with us. So, Dr. Aparna, I think now we are going to talk about the IC, LC, and the formation of IC, right?
Yes. Thank you so much, Dipti.
Yes.
And now, if you look at till now, we have seen the major terminologies which law has used.
Yes.
Right? Now onwards, I would like to tell you the applicability of this law. Then LC and IC. And if one company has to go for formation of IC, what are the basic things a company needs to look at? Okay. So if you look at the applicability of this law, it's very important that this law is applicable to entire India, including Jammu and Kashmir.
Entire India,
including Jammu and Kashmir.
Okay.
First. Then every company, whether you're a small company, your mid-scale company or your large-scale company, all the company needs to have, you know, IC, that is internal committee.
Okay.
Okay. Now in this, the major very important number is number 10.
Number 10.
Like, for example, if your company has got people less than 10.
Okay.
Okay. Then if any incidents happen, any employee can approach LC, that is called local committee.
Local committee.
Yes, which is formed by the district officer, nodal officer, and which is done on the district level.
District level.
Yes.
Okay.
And if you have employees more than 10, 10 and more than 10, then you need to have IC.
IC.
That is called internal committee.
Okay.
Okay.
So here what I understand is, like, if any organization who has less than 10 employees,
right?
So if any case happen within the organization, so they can approach to the LC,
right?
That is which falls under the district level.
Absolutely. Local committee.
Local committee. Hmm. And if any organization which has 10 or more than 10 employees, and if anything happens, sexual harassment case arises, so
right,
it should be handled by the IC committee.
Yes. See, look at the objective of this act. The objective of the act is anywhere any incidents happen, any woman, you know, should have a redressal mechanism. And if she has to approach anyone, she should not feel that I am working with a small company, where should I go? So that is where LC comes into the picture.
Mm-hmm.
If you remember, we saw workplace.
Yes.
And in that, for housemaids also, we said house is workplace.
Yes.
So any incidents happens, she can go to LC.
Okay.
And another people can go to IC. LC is approachable to anyone. So that is not a problem. So if you look at the applicability, it is applicable to entire India, including Jammu and Kashmir. And this is what it is. Like, I'll tell you one more thing, that this act has divided industries into two types.
Mm-hmm.
One is organized sector and another is unorganized sector. So if you look at this, 10 and more than 10 will fall under organized sector, and the people who have got less than 10 will fall under unorganized sector. Is this clear?
Yes.
So this is the major difference between LC and IC and the applicability of the law. Now the formation, like, for example, tomorrow you join any startup and you want, or you are working in a particular company and you do not know how to form IC, that is that also mentioned in our act. So if you want to form an IC, very important is IC, that is internal committee, will have a presiding officer. Now the presiding officer has to be a female. Okay.
Is it mandatory?
It is mandatory that we need to have a female who will be the presiding officer.
Mm-hmm.
Many companies will come and say, we do not have female employees. The act and the law will first of all will ask, what are the industry you are into that there cannot be a single female can work?
Yes.
So it is a big question on your diversity strategies. So you need to have a female employee. Second, very important. So are you clear on presiding officer?
Presiding
officer. Yes.
It should be a woman.
It has to be a female employee.
Female employee.
Second, very important, this act talks about you need to have two members. How many members?
Two members.
Two members from any department. Not necessarily it should be from HR or anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
any department.
Okay.
Now there is no mandate that two members should be females.
Female.
No.
Okay.
It can be males or females.
Okay.
But when you are forming an IC, always have male and female employees combination.
Yes.
So that once a person comes and approaches you, he or she will have a trust that, you know, meri yahan pe sunwai hogi.
Yes, they can come to you
yes.
and raise their complaint.
Right. So that is about two members. Now you can have five, you can have seven.
Okay.
But if you remember last time, we discussed about confidentiality part.
Yes.
So more the members, lesser the confidentiality.
Yes.
So you need to have the proper balance of men and women
okay.
as well as members are concerned.
Okay.
Is this
IC members.
Now, another part in IC is you need to have one external member. Why do we need external member? First, external member comes with the expertise as far as this act is concerned, one. Second very important thing is this, the person can be working with NGO,
uh-huh.
can have a knowledge about this particular act.
Okay.
And
so the person should have expertise in POSH.
Yes. He
okay.
or she should know ins and outs about the POSH.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Yes.
Very important, when the external member comes into the picture, then the biasness comes down. Right, like for example, if I know you right from the beginning,
mm-hmm.
okay, and you come with XYZ record and you come with this, you know, for example, with a complaint. And if I say, Ditti is just like that, no wonder this has happened with her, what will happen? But the external member will bring complete different kind of mindset which is neutral. And let me tell you one thing, IC members are very important. You need to Very important is have a trust in your IC members.
Mm-hmm.
Second very important thing is this, they are trained to take this kind of, I mean the kind of capacity building trainings they go through is a completely different process.
Okay.
Okay. So if you think that do they have a knowledge, certainly company has to make sure that they have a knowledge and they need to conduct a lot of capacity building training sessions for IC members.
Okay. So I have one more question here.
Please.
As we discussed in our previous videos,
hmm.
that organization should conduct the POSH trainings every year,
hmm.
right?
Hmm.
So it is compulsory for the IC members as well?
See, it is for both.
Okay.
Okay. Now let me tell you, even the law says once,
mm-hmm.
no one has stopped you to conduct twice and thrice as and when required.
Okay.
Because IC membership may keep on changing. Like for example, today both of us are IC members
mm-hmm.
and I resigned from the company.
Hmm.
Training session. Getting my point? So employee sensitization trainings are completely different
mm-hmm.
and IC is completely different
yes.
and very important is power of IC. When IC members sit together, they have a power of a civil court.
Civil court.
That's right. So whatever judgment they give, they will be giving in a very different way and nobody can challenge them. Different way, I mean to say, the investigation will be conducted, everything, and nobody can challenge them.
Okay.
So as far as timelines are concerned, IC members needs to follow the certain timelines, which is the mandate and which is the best part of this act. So anything happens, you will get a verdict in a stipulated time period. Now, very important, when a complainant can complain. A complainant can complain within 3 months of any of any incidents has happened, okay, or the last incident. Now, even though it is 6 months, 7 months, complaint can be taken. It is completely IC's power or IC's decision whether they want to take the complaint or not. But law has mentioned 3 months.
3 months.
Right? Then, very important, the other respondent should go the copy of the complaint within 7 days.
Okay.
Okay. So other party who is involved in this should receive a notice within 7 days.
7 days.
Yes. Then the entire complaint procedure should happen within 90 days.
90 days.
Yes. Now see, 90 days is again a very important number, that within 90 days the entire process should be completed.
With the resolution.
Absolutely.
Great.
Okay. So, within Then after 10 days, you know, so for example, if we say 10 days, what will happen within 10 days of completion of inquiry, submission of report will happen to the employer, to an employer, okay? And then within 60 days, employer needs to take the action which IC has suggested.
Okay.
Okay? So these numbers are clear, right? So now, what are going to be the punishments in this? So most of the time people say that termination. Yes, maximum cases terminations will happen. Okay, if you, a particular person or the other party found guilty, then. Otherwise, service rule is followed. Second important thing is this, written apology can be taken. Now it depends on the what kind of severity of the act has happened. Right, the warning can be given. Withholding of promotion can be done, then withholding of increments can be done. Okay, so these are the major things which are covered when you look at the punishment as concerned. But nowadays, looking at the scenario, the way things are happening, companies have zero tolerance for such kind of acts.
Yes.
Kyunki, for example, who will decide what is the severity? Kisi ne aapko touch kiya yahan tak? Is that fine? Or yahan tak aaye? Is that fine? Kisi ne aapko galti se dirty message bheja? Is that fine? Who will decide? Very important is zero tolerance for any kind of act. This is what companies are doing, and then the termination happens. Right?
But we have the sensitivity of the incident.
Yes.
And the outcomes.
Yes.
Is very important.
Right.
For the companies.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Because see, the thing is this, ultimately what major matters is what kind of message you are giving to other employees.
Yes.
That there is no, you know, chalta hai kind of attitude.
Yes.
If anyone does like this, he will be straight away out.
Organization has a major, major, huge role. You know?
Major role.
Major role.
Right. And it has to come from top.
Yes.
It has to come from top.
Mm-hmm.
So today if we look at it, in today's session we have seen what is LC, what is IC, what is the applicability. I think number 10 is very clear to
you. Yes.
Then we have seen the timeline.
Yes.
And we have seen the punishment.
Yes, plus organized and unorganized sector.
Great, great.
Yes. So guys, hope you learned a lot from this session. So stay tuned, stay connected, and now be prepare yourself for the exam and get your free certificate. Thank you.
Thank you so much.